Hello everyone. Do you want to learn speed subtraction? Then stay tuned with me and watch the complete video. Let's solve all these questions. So here we will be using the rule all from 9 and last from 10. So the first step is you have to observe how many zeros are there in the question. So you can see here there are 4 zeros, right? So you have to separate all the zeros. We are dividing question into two halves. This will be your left half and this will be your right half. Okay. Now, from the left half, you have to reduce the number by 1. So, 9 becomes 8. Right? 9 minus 1 is 8. And here in the right hand side, you have to apply the rule all from 9 and last from 10. It means you have to subtract all these digits from 9 and only the last digit from 10. Okay. So, 9 minus 3 gives you 6. 9 minus 8 gives you 1, 9 minus 4 gives you 5, and 10 minus 9 gives you 1. So this is your answer. Alright, now let's check the second question. So here also again, step number 1 is you have to separate all the zeros. You have 4 zeros here, so you have to divide the question like this. Okay, this is your left half and this is your right half. Now in the left half, what do we do? We reduce the number by 1. Okay, so 4 minus 1 is 3. And here on the right side, you apply the rule all from 9, last from 10. Okay, so here, let's do addition instead of subtracting so that it will be pretty fast. So 2 plus 7 gives you 9, 8 plus 1 gives you 9, 0 plus 9 gives you 9 and 6 plus 4 gives you 10. Okay, so basically instead of subtracting all these from 9 and 10, I did the addition trick. Okay, now in this question, we have 3 zeros. So let's separate all the zeros like this. Now on the left side, you have 76 and 3. So first you have to subtract these two and then reduce by 1. Okay, so 76 minus 3 is 73 minus 1 gives you 72. And here again apply the rule all from 9, last from 10. So 9 plus 0 gives you 9, 8 plus 1 gives you 9, and 7 plus 3 gives you 10. So this is your answer. Now let's see this question. Here we have only 2 zeros, right? So let's separate these 2 zeros. Now 369 minus 2 gives you 367. Now reduce 367 by 1. So you get 366. And here again apply the rule all from 9, last from 10. So 7 plus 2 gives you 9 and 3 plus 7 gives you 10. Here in this question you have 4 zeros. So separate all the 4 zeros. Reduce this by 1. So you get 586. And here 3 plus 6 gives you 9, 8 plus 1 gives you 9, 1 plus 8 gives you 9, and 4 plus 6 gives you 10. So you can see that this method is pretty fast and you get the accurate answer. So let's do a few decimal problems. Now here if you see, we have to subtract this decimal number from the whole number. Okay, so first you have to arrange these numbers properly. So 4 I can write down as 4.0000. I have put 4 zeros. Why? Because I have 4 digits here. Alright. Now place this number below this. You have to place in such a way that the decimal should fall under the same line. Okay. Now you have to subtract using the same method. So step number 1 is you have to separate all these zeros. Okay. So draw a line here. Now the question is divided into two parts. This is your left part and this is your right part. Now in the left part, 4 minus 2 gives you 2 and reduce 2 by 1. So you get 1. And here apply the rule all from 9, last from 10. So 1 plus 8 gives you 9, 6 plus 3 gives you 9, 7 plus 2 gives you 9 and 8 plus 2 gives you 10. So this is your answer and you have to place point under the point. Okay, so let's see one more problem. So here you have to subtract 2.389 from 600. So 600 you will write down as 600.000. I have placed 3 zeros here because you have 3 digits here. Alright, now write the other number below this. So you will write like this. Now you have to subtract. So now the rule is you have to separate all the zeros. So you have here how many zeros? 5 zeros. So separate all the zeros like this. Okay. Now here on the left hand side you have 6. So 6 minus 1 gives you 5. And here you have to apply the rule, all from 9, last from 10. But here if you see, you don't have anything over here, right? So you can place one 0 here. So now 0 plus 9 gives you 9. 2 plus 7 gives you 9. You have decimal here, so place this decimal here. 3 plus 6 gives you 9. 8 plus 1 gives you 9. And 9 plus 1 gives you 10. So this is your answer. Now, let's see some special cases here. So in this case, again, the step number 1 remains same. You have to separate all these zeros. So draw one line here. Now 65 minus 1 gives you 64. And here you have to apply the rule, all from 9, last from 10. So here if you see, the last two digits are 0. Okay. So you have to apply the rule, all from 9, last from 10, only for these two digits, only for 5 and 8. Okay. So 5 plus 4 gives you 9 and 8 plus 2 gives you 10. And these two you have to copy down as it is. So this is your answer. Similarly here also, first we have to separate these three zeros. So we get 7, 8, 9 here. Reduce this by 1. So you get 7, 8, 8. And now here you have 1 0 here, right? So you don't apply this rule for on 0. You apply this rule only for 3 and 6, right? So 3 plus 6 gives you 9. 6 plus 4 gives you 10. And copy this 0 as it is. So this is your answer. So you can see that this method is very simple. Here no borrowing is involved, right? And there is no confusion. The calculation is very simple. And the chances of happening mistake is very less. So you get the accurate answer. Now, one thing you all must have noticed that here in these subtractions, the numbers which I have taken has more number of zeros. You can see here, you have more number of zeros, right? So yes, this trick is useful for such numbers. There is a trick which is applicable for any kind of number. You can find the link of that video in the description box below. So do watch that video. I hope you like this trick. So these are a few practice questions. So practice them and master this trick. So that's it for today. See you very soon with few more interesting tricks. Until then, goodbye. Take care.